Breaking news, the GPU market sucks right now. Okay, obviously that's not breaking news. However, there are GPUs, if you look hard enough, that are actually immune to the scalpers and bots. That's where this guy comes in. And what this is an NVIDIA Tesla M40. This is a GPU from 2015 based on the Maxwell architecture. It's got 12 gigabytes of GDDR5 RAM, 3072 CUDA cores, and it's the same chip that's in the Titan X. So a pretty solid but old GPU. And the best part is that you can get it for about $170-ish US. So why is it immune to the scalpers? Why don't people want this? Why is it so cheap? Well, the main reason, it sucks at mining. You're not gonna get any use out of it as a miner, so that's why scalpers don't want it. Secondly, if you look closely, let me know if you notice something strange about this card. Yeah, there's no video output, so strange, right? Don't worry, we can get around this. And thirdly, there's no fan on it, so what's that about? So yeah, the Tesla M40 is not designed for gamers. It's not really designed for consumers. It having no video output or fans is pretty much an obvious reason that it's not for consumers. This is designed to go in a server for deep learning or other graphic-based applications, and specifically a 1U server that has a lot of static air pressure going from front to back, so that's how this will be cooled. But we have a way around that. And I've been tricking you guys the whole time. This is actually empty. There's no card on it. I've taken it off, and it is now looking like this. So how are we gonna use the card? Let's find out. All right, so this is essentially exactly what it looks like. It is an AIO designed for a graphics card. I got it off Amazon. It's from a company called ID Cooling. This is the ID Cooling Ice Flow 240. It's a 240 millimeter rad connected to your GPU with another fan on it to help cool the VRMs. And I did not have high expectations for this, but it works. It works surprisingly well. If you want to see how I put this together, I did a live stream where I did it all live. And if you want to check that out, I will link it in the description as well as right here. It's pretty decently long, so feel free to skip through. Basically, it wasn't a bad experience at all getting it put together, but there are some nuances. Obviously, when you're working with a very strange GPU like this, the front bracket doesn't really have anywhere to mount to anymore, so I had to use an M.2 screw with a nut to help it stay secure. And it kind of works. Okay, so we solved our cooling problem, but what about the fact that there's still no video output? Well, I asked you guys in a YouTube poll, if you had a Tesla M40, what would you use it for? Whether that's a cloud gaming server, transcoding, whether that's for handbrake, proxies, or for Plex or something, or if you want to do machine learning. And the top response was that you would trade it for a handful of Cheez-Its and a grape Kool-Aid. So, be right back. Hey, can I have some of those Cheez-Its?
No.
What if I give you this NVIDIA Tesla M40?
What am I supposed to do with that?
I don't know, put it in your home server? Okay, well, can I at least have the drink?
No, it's mine. Go finish your video.
All right, she actually let me have the grape Kool-Aid. All right, so the actual plan with the card is to install on my server and use it as a gaming machine. And I also wanted to try transcoding on it and turn it into a kind of automated proxy machine using Handbrake, where I can drop all my footage from my videos into a directory and Handbrake will automatically pick them up and create proxies using the Tesla M40. And for machine learning, I'm not a machine learning person. So based on the specs provided, I know it's pretty decent, but anybody out there who has experience running machine learning programs or doing any type of work in machine learning, let me know your thoughts on this card. But let's go install it in the server and I will be back with some performance updates. Oh, one thing to note before is that the power pin on the back. That is not PCIe standard. That is 8-pin CPU. So if you have an extra CPU, 8-pin coming from your power supply, you can use that for this. Or if you don't, just get a PCI 6-pin to CPU 8-pin adapter off Amazon for like $5. So I'm gonna go install this. Be right back. All right, we are back. And there are two ways you can go about getting video out from the Tesla M40. One way is easier. I'll talk about that. Basically, if you have integrated graphics on your processor or another maybe smaller graphics card in your machine already, you can just plug the Tesla M40 into another PCI slot, use the output from another source like your integrated graphics, and then go into whatever program you want to run on the Tesla M40, so probably a game, and set that to use the M40 as its graphics. It's a pretty straightforward process. I will link an article in the description below if you want to go that route. I'm going a different route, so I'm going with one that's a bit more complicated, and it's essentially straight from Jeff over at Craft Computing. He did a video a while ago using the same Tesla M40 where he wanted to get it set up and running games. I am going with exactly his setup. So if you want to see how to set this up, I will link his video in the description below as well as the guide that he created. It's pretty easy to follow. I mean, you need three pieces of software. You need Parsec, you need TypeVNC, and you need a virtual audio cable. And once you have all that set up, you essentially just connect to the machine using Parsec and it'll act just like a normal computer. And if you're using this across LAN, it's extremely responsive. We're talking like less than a millisecond latency. Now, I've done a video on Parsec. I'm not gonna cover it in this video. If you want to check that out, I will link a link. I'll put a link up here, but let's dive into it. Let's take a look at the performance in gaming on the Tesla M40. All right, so here you can see in Parsec, my Tesla M40 machine is showing up. All we have to do is click connect. Just like that, we are into our Tesla M40 desktop. I'm going to open up CPU ID and take a look at the temperatures and the specs. All right, so here's our Tesla M40 idling at 2728 degrees. So by this point, some of you are probably thinking, oh, I've seen shrouds, like 3D printed shrouds you can put on the Tesla M40 to help cool it. And those don't work. And the reason I know that is because I tried. I don't know why this exists. Jeff did it in his video. It didn't work. I thought maybe if I undervolted the M40, I could get some decent performance out of this thing with a little 40 millimeter fan. No, it sucks. So with our 240 millimeter AIO, we are looking at 28 degrees idle, which is cool, but the real thing is, what about under load? Stress test, let's run it. And when I did this with the tiny little 40 millimeter fan shroud thing, it instantly, over the course of about maybe a minute, got up to 90 degrees and thermally throttled. But in all of my tests, this hasn't gotten over 50 degrees. That's extremely impressive for that $100 AIO. So we're not gonna sit here and watch this for 10, 20 minutes, but you can see the GPU is at 100%. Its power is at 100%. This is a 250 watt TDP card. So the fact that this hasn't shot up to around 60 degrees already is very impressive. So for gaming, I ran three games. I started with League of Legends, which is probably the easiest game in the world to run. So 1080p max settings, we were getting 120 FPS, which is way more than you need. This is limited to 60 FPS on Parsec, so 120 is way more than we can even use. And the latency across LAN on Parsec was only like 1 to 2 milliseconds, which is extremely playable for a fast Twitch game like League of Legends. So let's step it up to something a lot harder to run. Let's do The Witcher 3. The Witcher 3, 1080p, ultra settings. The only thing I turned off was Hairworks because it's pointless. And with those settings, we were getting 63 FPS, which again, with our 60 FPS threshold, extremely playable. Imagine just setting up whatever computer you want in your house and having a centralized gaming machine that you can just pick up and start your games from with extremely good quality wherever you are in the house. from any machine. It's awesome. Now to push it further, we went with Borderlands 3. I set it to high settings and we did dip below 60 FPS. We were sitting in around the high 40s, sometimes creeping up to 60 in certain environments. But again, it's playable. If you want to step down the quality to low or medium, or even the resolution down to 720p, you will get a much better experience. So gaming on the Tesla M40 is actually really good. If you want to compare it to an actual GeForce card, it sits right about where the GTX 1070 is. So if you look at the prices for a GTX 1070 right now, significantly higher than a Tesla M40, even with the $100 AIO. So if you're willing to put in a little bit of elbow grease, the Tesla M40 isn't a bad buy for a remote gaming server. Now what about something a data center card like the Tesla M40 is more designed for, and transcoding? My idea, like I said before, was to throw this at a VM, have it run Handbrake, and automatically create proxies of my videos. So that's what I did. So in Handbrake, I took my Pi for a Week challenge video. That's about 35 minutes long, encoded in H.265 and 1080p, and attempted to make a proxy down to 720p. And I did this in H.264. Now, how did it fare? So here you can see the results from my two tests, one where I did GPU encoding and one where I did CPU encoding, both in H.264. So for a 34-minute video, the GPU encoding took about 9 minutes and 5 seconds and produced a file that is 942 megabytes. Kind of high for a 720p proxy. Moving over to the CPU encode, now this is 8 threads of my AMD EPYC 7302, and that took 12 minutes and 30 seconds and produced a file that's 361 megabytes. That's less than half of the size from the Tesla M40 render. So while you do get faster encoding on the Tesla M40, you do get a much better compression and quality out of CPU encoding. So let's compare that to my main machine over here, which is running a Ryzen 9 5950X and a RTX 3080 Ti. So GPU encoding, H.265, NVENC, with that same video doing GPU encoding on the 3080 Ti, it rendered in 3 minutes and 44 seconds and took up 806 megabytes. So there's your comparison. I mean, 3 minutes and 44 seconds versus 9 minutes and 5 seconds. Yeah, but I mean, this is a much more expensive card. And CPU encoding followed that same trend. It finished in 4 minutes and 58 seconds with a total file size of 240 megabytes. So if you're looking to set up an automated proxy encoding server like I am, I'd still recommend going with CPU encoding. Although it does take a little bit longer than GPU encoding, the file sizes are much smaller and you do get better quality. However, if you're looking at real-time transcoding for something like Plex, the M40 might be something you'd like to investigate. You can save a good bit of CPU cores for other virtual machines or services in your home server while just allocating a single Tesla M40 to do all the transcoding for Plex. According to NVIDIA, it can handle 4K 30 FPS transcodes at one time. So if that's in your ballpark, then maybe this is for you. All right, so overall, what do I think about the Tesla M40? Well, if we weren't living in a world where GPU prices were insane, then I would say absolutely not, do not buy it. However, the reality is the GPU market sucks and I can't change that. I don't have enough subscribers. So yeah, help me out. Subscribe.
Subscribe, please.
So all things considered, if you want to get your hands dirty and pick up a Tesla M40, as well as some cooling solution, then I mean, it's usable. Gaming comparatively to a GTX 1070 and pretty decent encoding or transcoding for Plex. If you can snag a Tesla M40 and a cooling solution for around $250, I'd say it's worth it. Otherwise, just pick up a Ryzen 5700G and call it a day. So now I'm curious, after seeing this video, do you plan on picking up an M40? Or if you have one, what are you using it for? I'd actually be curious to know. Let me know down in the comments. But that's all I have for today. If you like this video, be sure to drop a like below. If you like content like this, please consider subscribing. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.